It's Uncensored. Today I'm with the boys from Atta System. Whoop, whoop, whoop. They have their own YouTube channel. Go check it out. They're freaking hilarious. All of them are UH alumni. We have All Americans, a national team player. These boys made the run together. They were the number one team in the nation, like all season last year, I'm pretty sure, right, guys?
Yeah, they were.
A lot of it, yeah.
Nice. That's awesome. I know, Gage, you were like back-to-back first time in UH history for some libero skills or something.
Yeah. Seventh player. He was a seventh player, but he's back-to-back National Libero of the Year, and he was back-to-back first team All-American. So
nice.
Rare company.
Just go ahead and dust that off the shoulder just a little bit.
Yeah. Well, Joe here, I guess we're naming accolades. Joe, first team All-American, second team All-American, you know, multiple recipient of National Center Award, National Player of the Award or of the Week and Month. Should have won National Player of the Year, but that was
of the day too.
We're not gonna of the day, you know, of the minute.
Not a lot of accolades for Joe.
He was a assistant, a coach slash captain as well, and national team member, of course. You know, he's been on countless national team trips. My boy Max over there. Gotta show some my boy Max. Fired from zero. Now look at him now, man. Look at him now.
Sir.
Well, as per usual, none of my guests know what game we're playing on the show. And today I brought these boys on to play Never Have I Ever. So let's go.
Let's go.
Some juicy.
Never say never.
Never, never, never. Pick it up.
Are you ready? You have your makeshift little panels, yes and no.
Professional grade.
Professional. Okay, so first question, and this is an honesty game, guys. Like, let's try and be a little bit honest here, okay?
I'll be honest.
Give the people what they want. Okay.
I will.
So, never have I ever cruised to Sandy's or Mox on game day.
On a game day?
No.
Max, we can't see.
No way. No way going to Sandy's on the game day.
No. 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 We're very serious.
The thing is, in Hawaii, because there's fans who are there. If they see us there, like, well, they'll send an email to Charlie.
Yeah,
people hear about it.
We wouldn't do it in the first place, but if somebody considered it, like, our coaches would find out, even if you think you're sneaky.
Got it. Celebrity problems, I forgot.
Not quite.
Never have I ever took more than 5 Hawaiian Sun drinks home after the game, after the aunties brought all those goodies. How many Hawaiian Suns have y'all taken?
The most? I've taken
for
home
sure
a
five. For sure 5.
I took home the entire cooler one time.
Yeah.
The most I've taken is maybe 2. That's it, though.
Philip takes like 8 of them while we're still drinking them. Like, we're not even having to go.
Philip takes the actual cooler.
Yeah.
Joe, did you just go up to the auntie and just say, like, can I have all of them?
So my first 2 years, I was always known for being the last out of the locker room, like showering and stuff. And I would show up, and I was always the last one to eat that meant. And so they would just have this full cooler thing. They like, just take it all. I'm like, all right. So they hand it to me. I'd take the entire cooler full.
Never have I ever gotten a fan's phone number during autograph signings.
That's a no, too. No way.
Oh my God, no, Joe, just
let that go. No, I'm pretty sure that's a no. I don't think I've ever done that. I'll try to think. It's been 4 years.
Are you talking about like to hit on or like to hit on?
Yeah, yeah, good question.
Is that?
No, I'm talking about to hit on, like not volleyball lessons or anything.
No.
I mean, most of these girls like 13.
No, yeah, no.
It would be a little weird if they must do that and be like, ah. Either there's no in between. They're either like 13 or 50.
Maybe Colton has. No.
Oh my!
I'm gonna get him in trouble. He's never done that.
Scott Hartley, shout out. Do you think maybe a fan came up to him or two? I remember.
For sure. Like, I've been asked to prom a couple times with a sign.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cute.
I had to play because we were traveling, so I always use that as an excuse. Oh, I think we're traveling that week.
I just said
the week of your prom, we're traveling.
Yeah.
Virtual prom. That's what they gotta do now.
So you basically just broke girls' hearts right and left.
That's what Gage does.
That's what Joe does, honestly, right, Gage?
Joe.
Never have I ever heckled another women's team during a women's volleyball game, indoor or beach, to the point of making one of them cry.
Oh.
Yeah, we have. It wasn't, wait, me directly made him cry? Or part of the group led to it.
Collective unit. Y'all are collective unit.
All right, then fine, yeah.
And we didn't even go that far. We truthfully didn't even go that far.
Some people are just mentally weak. What can I say? Too easy. If you're crying because of a heckler.
It wasn't our doing.
What team was it?
My lawyer says that we're not. We're contractually
obligated. No, I would say if I remembered. We never crossed the line. We never crossed the line with people, but we definitely were trying to get in their heads.
Remember that thing with the helmet? We kept saying Dalton wore his moped helmet in there.
Yeah, Dalton wore his moped helmet.
And then someone got hit in the head.
Stein wore just his robe one time. Literally, just his robe. I'm like, Stein, keep it on. Make sure you remember that that's the only thing you have on right now. So we had to have somebody watch him.
That's hilarious. Did he have any issues, like, flashing anybody? I feel like that's a safety.
No. Oh, he would have.
Someone came down, though, yeah?
Yeah, he got yelled. Well, because he was just being, like, so, like, he was so loud and obnoxious.
Never have I ever rode my moped with more than two people on it.
Yeah. That's a yeah. Definitely have.
I once fit myself, Rattle Parapunov, and Jake Myers, who's about 6'10", on a moped. So imagine those huge bodies on there. On a normal moped, too. So it wasn't like a jacked up one or anything.
We moved your bed, too, Gage. Remember that?
Oh, we rode, yeah, Max. No, we moved your bed. Remember that?
Oh, yeah.
We took Max's bed from his dorms, and we put it on a moped. And we drove it to my dorm.
Nice twin bed. Just sat on the bed.
Absolute ledge move.
Joe, what's your story?
Freshman year, Emily Maglio and Clay Greeley we wanted to go get some food or something. I'm like, all right, we're packing on. Because they wanted to walk super far. I'm like, I'm not walking that far. So we're packing on, and we're coming up, and on the way back, now that everybody's graduated, the coach just can't get mad at him. We ate it. Super bad. We fell over. That wasn't good, but.
Hold on again.
Never have I ever went to the beach on purpose to, like, enjoy it in Waikiki.
Like, go to Waikiki.
I mean,
if we don't have much time, an outrigger, I mean, that's considered.
Oh, well, outrigger, yeah. I mean, that's nicer than, like.
It's all on the same strand.
The grime of Waikiki.
Yeah.
Like. Some parts of it, right?
No. Well, Waikiki is like, it just depends where I think. Oh, Waikiki. Like, there's some nice empty parts.
Yeah, for sure.
Just kind of carousing.
Never have I ever written a love song for a girl.
Oh,
love song.
I'm not in the wrong version for that one.
Maybe Max. He's the only one who writes songs.
Max.
Yes.
Max.
Song for me. That's what I was looking for.
I've written a love song for Gage before. No.
He's saying it right to me, right now.
He's my muse. No, yeah, for sure. But I think the key for that is just you can't tell people who it's about. Just try to keep it general, lyrically.
Right,
exactly. Have you ever performed the song for the girl you wrote it about?
Oh, for sure, yeah. And then just
dude, Max is the musical mastermind behind everything.
I just didn't say. I just said, oh, yeah, it's unrelated. But.
Oh, that's cute.
Oh, man. Joe's not in relationships, man.
I would never sing a song. That would just automatically, no shot. If Gage and I tried to sing a song, that would be no shot. We're freaking moves there.
Wait, okay. I want to know, Joe, what do you look for in a relationship since you're anti-relationship?
Buckle up.
Anti-relationship. You got to give a little bit of context with that. Because
he's anti-love.
Because it's during season, my senior year, I'm like, there's too many distractions going on in the off season. So I'm like, there's no relationships during season. That was my rule. People took it out of context. I want people to be happy and stuff, but if it's getting in the way of the team, I always think the boys should be first. I always, especially in college, like the boys should always be first. And
hey, what are you laughing about?
It's really like
Joe, man.
It's really by a me, Stein, and Rado were the biggest advocates for that rule.
For sure.
And my mom and dad.
Do you have a problem with your brother being in a relationship?
Oh, he's cool. He's honestly, Joe, let me just comment on this and then Joe, you have the floor. Okay. He's been super supportive the whole time, honestly. So
that's great. That's fantastic.
Except during season.
Yeah.
Except every day.
He's always, he needs to be always in season though. So
every day.
Never have I ever told my teammate they can't have their girlfriend during season, and never have I ever made my teammate break up with someone during season.
I've never made somebody break up. I just told him not to get into the relationship. And he gave the reason to the girls because Joe will kill me if I get into a relationship. He said that. I'm like, okay, you don't need to say that. You give a better reason. Makes me look like
that's Rada.
Really bad.
Even in names. Rada's actually part of the Out of System boys. He's just behind the camera a lot of time.
Yeah.
Right.
Wait, so Joe, you never answered my question. What are you looking for in a relationship? The ladies need to know.
I don't know how to answer that, but but for me, I don't know. Relationship, like, I always know that I eventually will want to push me to be better. Like, I don't want somebody who's just kind of, like, along just to – I don't know. Does that make sense? Like, I
want to the ride. You don't want better. That. You
like,
want
to, as an athlete, as a person, everybody. I always think that's the best relationship. But, at the same time, who understands like my lifestyle, whether it's as an athlete or eventually I want to coach, like understands the sports world and is not gonna have issues with like me being super obsessed with whatever team I'm coaching or playing on. Like that to me has always been my first priority. I think like for me, I know that I'll be happiest with somebody who understands that. That makes sense.
And in the sports world, I think athleticism also is rookie.
I don't know. To be honest, I truly don't know exactly what I would look for in a relationship because I've never been like in a super long one. So
nice. That's a good answer. We'll take it.
Okay.
Max, do you have anything to chime in?
About Joe, what Joe's looking for, or me, or myself?
What am I looking for, bro? Why don't you tell everybody what I'm looking for?
No, I think I never thought these words would leave my mouth, but I think Joe, I agree with what Joe just said about relationships. I think that it is important to have
someone.
I mean, don't make me regret it because I think that it's important to have someone that is going to not butt in too much if you have other stuff that you're focused on, but also be supportive at the same time. So well said, Joe, on that one.
Well done, Joseph. Is that your opinion?
Joseph Montana Worsley, it is.
Joseph Montana Worsley, yeah.
There it is.
Never have I ever sent a bad or naughty text to the wrong person.
Oh, man.
I've sent a naughty text to the right person.
Yeah, that's enough.
Woo!
But you sent it to the right person is like
what was that?
But you said you sent it to the right person?
Yes, I did.
It didn't end up well for him. He's just laughing hysterically.
This is getting wild.
Oh, yeah. You had to put the haterade shades on.
I'm blocking all them haters.
Never have I ever woke up in a strange place and had no clue how I got there.
Dude, I think that happens like every night. I'm always just feel so disoriented when I wake up.
Like there's what my first day in Germany. Actually, I woke up and I'm like, "What? I'm in Germany."
Yeah.
Was ist das?
Was ist exactly? Besides that, no.
No, you never woke up on a random part of the island and were like, "This is interesting."
Nope.
Not yet. Yeah.
I see a lot of giggling like happening. I'm just not really sure if
that's how those two are, honestly. You wanted to get into something professional with these two, that's just the way it's gonna be. There's gonna be a lot of giggling going on, and I love it. I wouldn't have it any other way.
That's it should be.
All right, since we all know that we all travel a lot with the lifestyle we have, Never have I ever stolen something from a hotel room.
What do you mean, like toilet paper?
I've taken, yeah.
Before the
for sure have done that.
Before the quarantine, this is when toilet paper was going crazy. Like everyone like needed toilet paper. That's when we heard when we were like, our season was done.
Back when everyone needed toilet
paper. I found the maid's cart and on my floor. She was like in a room or something. And I found it, and we were on a way trip, and they had a special stash for toilet paper because it was, like, so in demand, they had to keep some. But I found it while she was working in the room, in a different room, and I stole, like, 3 or 4 of them, and then I ran back to my room. And then I came home, and I used the toilet paper. Nice story, Gage.
Typical.
Gotta do what you gotta do in quarantine. I mean, it's, like, survival of the fittest at this point. If you see the toilet paper, you know.
Yeah, totally.
Max, what was your answer?
I said no, but I don't know if we're counting like just shampoo and stuff like
that. I feel like toiletries count, but like everyone kind of takes that. Like I take the toiletries.
I think that's a pretty normal thing to do, honestly. Yeah.
Yeah, like a wallet or something. Well, oh, it wasn't my hotel room. No. Oh, our hotel room. nothing for my hotel room. I didn't know. I've like a PS4 maybe.
Yeah.
This is the casual stuff. It's like it's pretty normal, as Max says.
It's like a TV, like here or there, or like a lamp.
Exactly. Some cutlery.
Never have I ever blamed my brother for being late to practice or a game or in general.
For being late.
I blamed him for everything. So
Joe, I'm gonna also say yes that Joe has done that. Joe, we should tell the story about the first practice where I don't know if this happened at the same time where Gage slept in or something.
Yeah.
It was that the same one where he showed up wearing a reversible Adidas jersey?
He showed up an hour late. He was a freshman. I don't know, a couple weeks into practice.
Yeah.
Shows up and Charlie's coming to me asking me where's he getting. I'm like, I live off campus. He's living on campus as a freshman. I'm like, I have no idea. And Charlie's like, where's Gage? Gage walks in here to run the entire hour, nonstop, circles.
No one else has ever had to do that. There have been plenty of people late.
Just Gage.
Breaks only for vomiting.
Gage always gets stuck with all the worst punishments, though.
But I don't think he was ever late again after that. So he's an early guy.
Learned your lesson. Yeah, knock on wood. All right, everyone needs to be honest now. Never have I ever cried during a Disney movie.
Oh, for sure.
Sure. I don't remember which one it was. But I for sure have.
I never cry during movies.
You've never cried during a movie?
When have I cried during a movie?
I don't know. I'm not
exactly. Never cried Dumbo. During a movie.
Dumbo. I've for sure, like, saying Dumbo is just excessively sad, just right off the bat. It's just, or Bambi, too. Like, it's just.
Dude, Bambi,
like,
that was a tough one.
I know. Why did they have to make it that sad? It could have been a pretty good movie.
There were a couple ones I was like, oh my God. I mean, I cry a lot of movies. Like, all
Infinity
my top.
War.
So basically, Joe doesn't believe in love and doesn't have
sex. He's making me sound like a horrible person.
How could you be so heartless?
Making me sound like a horrible person, everybody. No, at least Rado, my opposite from last year, he's got my back always.
When do I not have your back, Joe? Name a time I haven't had your back.
When I argue with Gage.
I got your back.
Okay, well, aside from that.
That's every day, though.
Yeah, okay, fine.
If you had to name one person on your team throughout your 4 years,
we all know this.
Roster your four years, Joe, and for Gage and Max as well thus far, top two people that need to be the Bachelor.
Wait.
On the Bachelor.
Ready?
I have a question. Are you saying that would be really good on The Bachelor or need to be on it because they're single?
No, that would be good as The Bachelor. So
easy.
There's like
Colton and Capone Faye. Colton Capone Faye. They're both very sensitive people. They're both adored by most girls of most age groups, specifically the high school age group. I think that's who watches the show mostly too. But both of them would for sure be candidates for that show.
I can 110% back that for a fact. Yeah. More so for, I know Capone better than I know Colton, but I know Colton, obviously.
Colton the most, to be honest, then Capone.
Never have I ever been in love.
Oh, you know what?
Put your heart out there, Max.
Oh, I love to see it. So cute, guys.
So opposite.
I mean, like, Joe, your answer is 100% expected.
As expected. As delivered. Yeah.
I think for me, like, I've liked people a lot, but I don't know.
I really, really.
You have such a way with words.
You're like, I like you how I like my cat or dog. Like,
people are going to watch this.
You don't
and
love
just
your
be
cat
like,
or dog?
Just like an acquaintance. Sorry, not like that.
No, no. I mean,
I love my dog.
There's definitely. I'm not going to say that.
No, yeah, you are. So say it.
I love my dog more than I'll ever love a female.
My dog, I'll do anything for sure.
You wouldn't take him out.
I take him out every single day.
All right, recently.
It's every day, bro.
It's every day, bro.
It's every day.
Stop bro. Saying that.
Jake Paul.
It's every day, bro.
Wait, Max, is the one that you were in love with the one you wrote the song for?
One of them, yeah.
Cute.
Babe.
Fuck you. Never have I ever lied in this game.
Oh, I don't think I did.
Wow.
I thought I was truthful.
We're pretty open for the most part.
You can ask anything.
Pause for the out of system boys. There it is.
You know it.
Never have I ever been drunk before noon.
I'm hammered right now.
But it's 1 o'clock, baby.
Responsible.
No.
We're focused. Focused on our craft.
What about out of season? Like at the beach or something?
We out of season, Charlie, we're always trained in the mornings all the time. And we're just like, I don't know, we weren't crazy or anything at all. By the time like I was junior senior, we were a really boring team in general.
I get a buzz off of just the waves alone, honestly.
Yeah. I mean, we'd hang out and stuff, but we weren't like there's some other schools who are wild. We're like, we weren't like that. My last year, if you ask the guys, they'll say it too. We're like grandpas almost.
It's funny comparing the teams from when like Como and Sunny and like.
Yeah, we've heard stories.
That whole crew. It was fun. It was a fun time. I definitely have been drunk before noon because at UCI, we have something called dodgeball and it's Memorial Day weekend. Every weekend, it was like a tradition, like since before I got there. Basically, there's like a huge bracket. There's men and women's, and it's costume. It's dress up like six man. National anthem's at 9 a.m. One year, we got it sponsored by like Monster, and there was a DJ, and it's just this like huge dodgeball tournament. And some people like don't even make it to dodgeball because like they start drinking at like 7 a.m. and like tip off is 9 and your entry fee is 330 racks per team and there's probably like 35 teams in the tournament or something like that. So
holy
rage fest, huh?
Okay, because I have them on and because they're cracking me up and they're freaking hilarious, I'm gonna play firing questions.
Uh-oh. Okay.
Fire away.
Somebody call 911. Shawty fire burning on the dance floor. Whoa. What's up, Quan? Kingston, let's go. Hey. Red one.
Hey. Something that you do that annoys your siblings.
Talk about his relationship.
Breathe air. You can
or when I try to get him to do something, like try to get him to do the dishes or something.
When he tries to get me to do the dishes, I never have to tell him to do that, but he does it for me.
Gage never knows.
Like
me.
If he's cooking,
oh my god, cooking,
there's never like a get comfortable. He's got it. So I was like, oh Gage, can you do this? Oh Gage, can you do that? Can you do this? Can you do that? Always.
Favorite or sexiest DC or Marvel character?
Rocket Raccoon.
Nick Fury. For both.
A Green Lantern.
So you're invited to a party. What do you bring?
Country music playlist.
Snacks.
Brie cheese.
DiGiorno's.
Yeah.
What's something that you hate that everyone else loves?
Something that I hate.
Chocolate.
Also, I don't hate it, but I'm not a fan of it. The like superhero movies and stuff. I've never like been a huge fan of them, besides Batman. But besides that, I'm not like a huge fan of superhero movies.
I can go with Joe, but maybe more like action movies. They're kind of. What'd you say about Wonderwall?
Wonderwall. That's
one. It's a great song. It's actually a really good song.
I feel sexy when. ..
Always. Clothes on or clothes off.
Yeah, when the sun rises.
Gated for sure that. I don't. when I'm standing next to my brother.
Ooh.
The dynamic duo. He just radiates sexy off of him. Off of his luscious body off the Libero diet.
Well, thanks, guys. Thanks for coming on.
Thank you.
Check it. First of all, thank you, Victoria. Did an awesome job. We had a good time. If you guys want to check out our YouTube channel, Out of System, check that out. We'll be posting some vids and stay
some
tuned.
Really cool shows coming soon. Yeah. We have some really cool guests. Check it out. Check our social media pages out. We're starting a TikTok. We're getting out there in the social media world. But thank you, Victoria. It's awesome. This is really cool.
Thank you. Of course. Yeah. Thanks, guys. Thanks for coming on.
Kickstart. Let's go. Hey.